Let's next talk about the somewhat controversial issue and also somewhat confusing issue of the role of scans in patients with breast cancer. I think patients with breast cancer often overestimate the benefit and need for scans, but in my own practice, we typically will do PET CT scans on patients with node-positive breast cancer, on patients with locally advanced breast cancer, and on patients with what's called inflammatory breast cancer. These are the more high-risk patients that have at least some likelihood of having established metastatic disease at the time of diagnosis. Although, interestingly, that percent is not very common. In low-stage patients, patients that are node-negative, I tend to discourage scans as the true positive rate, that is, of finding overt metastatic disease, is incredibly low, and the false positive rate, that is, finding abnormalities of the scan that are not due to the cancer, is more common than true positive. The dilemma there is that you've got a scan that shows something, you're not quite sure what it is, you're fairly convinced it's not the cancer, but you're left with something to evaluate, which may be stressful for the patient, and for which there may be no easy way, at least at that point in time, to determine the significance of that abnormality. In that case, the patient may remain quite nervous until one repeats the scan 3 to 4 months later to see if there's been a change. So in higher risk patients, I think scanning is appropriate, but in lower risk patients has not been beneficial, and I would try to discourage it.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.